Hi Aquarius, welcome. This is our weekly reading for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Quiring for the week of July 29th through August 4th, 2016. So Aquarius, I'm doing a general reading, see how it feels for you. We're all children of God, we're all psychic. So see what personal messages come through for you, which signs, symbols, bells, whistles, energies, cards, messages feel right for you, for whatever you're wondering, concerned, inquiring, confused, dreaming, praying about. In the end, Aquarius, always use your logic and intuition together to make sound decisions based in love for the highest and greatest good of everybody involved in the situation, in their situation, and so on. So we're all uplifted in love. In the end, remember how you ride these energetic waves that come through Aquarius is up to you. So see how it feels, and let's begin with our reading for Aquarius. All right, I have the wisdom of the oracle. We're gonna begin here. All right, so let's see what God, Source, Holy Spirit, our higher self, angels, and energies of love have for Aquarius. Sun, Moon, Rising, Curious. For the week of July 29th through August 4th, for the highest, greatest good of all. One card to begin with. And from the Romance Angels Oracle. One card for Aquarius. Let's see, wisdom to focus on this week in the romance, love, sexy communication, partnership, department. Whatever this is for you. And from the Angel Tarot. One card for Aquarius. Aquarius, I have the Tarot Illuminati deck for us. So let's pull three cards. The first is Wisdom. The second card is Blessings. And the third card is Lessons. Let's see what we have. So Aquarius, Wisdom. Aquarius, Blessings. That one. And for Aquarius, Blessings this week. Okay, let's begin. I'm going to show you my little layout I have on my canvas here. I kind of like this setup, but I forgot to show everybody what I was working with last week until the last few videos. So this is it. All right, let's begin, Aquarius. I'm going to start with, I feel like, the Angel Tarot. So you have the Five of Earth. So five, change. It's also like being left out in the cold, being left out in the dark, having fears financially, worry that you can't make this, that you can't handle that, that you're not meant to have this, that you're not, you know, you can't have this, you know, but it's affecting you physically. It's affecting you financially. It's affecting your, it's like, I feel like this card is when the swords somehow come into play in the Pentacles suit for us. So you're sort of letting your thoughts overwhelm you to the point where You're not making, you're making, either you made a wrong decision or there was a decision made that was wrong to force you into change, to create something to move, to create a push. But I feel like with this, it's up to you to have consciousness and to choose to step, to choose to push, to choose to move, to choose to change. You know, you can stay out in the cold and cry about it, or you can do something about it. You know, it's asking you to be a leader, asking you to be that spark of change. You know, this could be other people in the cold. Wait, let's see. It's fear surrounding money, the wisdom to accept help from others, and uncertain self-employment. So it's, you know, it's, you're starting the ball rolling and it's not quite tangible yet. You know, something came to change your direction, to change your vision, to change your focus, to change your journey, your path, you know, your, I want to say what you envision, what you imagine, what, where you want to go. And it's almost like you were going one way before and something came and slapped you or changed you or made you look a different direction for whatever reason. Perhaps you were in the cold a long time. You're like, it's kind of cold over there. And finally, I'm going to go and look this way where it's warmer. I'm going to step inside. I'm going to take action. I'm going to do something and envision something new. So it's like you see it before you. You can see the whole picture. You can see the blueprints. You can see the city. You can see your, I want to say your new property, almost like your new home. Perhaps someone's like moving. There needs to be a change and you can see your new house. You can see your new apartment. You can envision what you want, or it's asking you to start to try. Don't be stuck in what you don't have. Don't be stuck in what was sucky. You know, start to envision what you want, where you want to go, what you want to have, what is good for you, what wasn't good for you. You know, but don't stay in the what wasn't good for you. Move towards the what is good for you and envision it. Imagine it. Feel yourself in that home, in that room, in that place where you're comfortable, where you're satisfied, where you're doing something that your time is valuable and you're appreciated there. You know, it's like magic about to blossom and it's in your head. You just need to start to make it real and tangible. So don't let fears overwhelm what is going to be happening, what should be happening for you. It's magical and you can see it. So don't get stuck in the lack. Don't get stuck crying over spilled milk. Don't get stuck out in the cold when you can create your own warmth. Aquarius, that was a lot from that card. I also see you in a garden, like creating outdoor garden spaces. I see that a lot in these cards, but like even like a tree house for your kids or one of those awesome tents that suspends in the air from 3 points. I don't even know if they make that. Maybe that didn't work. Something like suspending, something with camping and tents or teepees, maybe even pyramids. Maybe somebody's going on an adventure in South America, I want to say, or Mexico somewhere where there's a jungle or a forest, Chichen Itza, Machu Picchu, somewhere no one's ever seen before, and there's something hidden, or you can envision where it is. That's a really specific thing for somebody. So if you have an idea of where something might be, maybe you have family history, maybe your past lives, you know, were there, and you just have this knowing about where something is, where this gem is, where this mystery is. I want to say like treasure. Look at this card. It's like the forest is here, and then the layer beyond, the layer behind that, you can see it. You know it's there. You know where to go. Just don't get discouraged. There's something big you're going to discover, Aquarius. Go for it. I want to say get out your metal detectors. You know? All right. That was a lot on one card. So you have unrequited love as your romance angel. So there's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. So don't you want chemistry? Don't you want attraction? You know, don't you want the person to feel exactly the same and you to read each other's minds and you'd be perfectly good on your own and not have to be on each other, have to have each other, but be there because you want to be. Wow, that was really a different turn on this card. But I see one person really into somebody and the other person just not really into them. It's just not there. It's not right. I want to say let it be. There's something better. If this is somebody that came into your life and like gave you the cold shoulder, maybe gave you the cold, something turned off, somebody got turned off somewhere. I want to say that your paths came together to learn what you did to create a spark for you to go somewhere better too. So sometimes we come together and we learn something at the time when we're supposed to learn it and we move on. You know, sometimes you come back around, but this usually means there's something better that's waiting for you. There's somebody that's already dreaming about you and you're not allowing it in because you're worried about the wrong person. So that's not everybody. Some of you are married happily, and then some of you, you know, aren't interested in a relationship. You like to be, I want to say, separate, you know, not get too emotionally involved and gushy with something. You like somebody independent and good. And when you decide to come together and have a good time, you're good. And then you go apart and you don't feel stressed because somebody's not with you all the time. So there's somebody coming in your life that's going to have the same balance as you, the same strength as you, the same independence as you, Aquarius. And you're going to know when you meet them. The chemistry is going to be real. It's not going to be pushed or forced or a power struggle or something you have to chase after or want so bad. And it's just not, you know, not happening. This is like you going this way and somebody else going that way so that you can both find something better, you know? Allow the universe to give you change if change comes. There we go, Aquarius, a change in the wind. So you have this zebra with this like clock tower. I see like a, like one of those, I want to see like little patios, those little round like gazebos that you get married under, or that's by a lake, like a lake house. These are things you can't control. This is when the universe comes and creates change that's supposed to happen for your greater good, you know? So don't get stuck in the storm. Navigate the storm. Use the storm to spark you to get somewhere else faster. You know, it's allowing shifts in how you feel, allowing yourself to come back in sync with things after things go out of sync, out of whack, when things got friction, when fiction was created, when change, you know, when the tornado came around and stopped and you're like, what the fuck just happened? What just happened? Allow your perception to change. Allow the winds of change to come and blow you something better. All right, let's get to your cards. You have Eight of Wands. So change coming quickly, quick change. Decisions that create quick change, quick moves. A lot of emails, a lot of messages, a lot of energy moving one way or the other way. So be conscious of the energy you're putting out. You know, make it positive, make it vibrationally beautiful for you to have beautiful things, and open your arms. Open your arms. You have the Four Pentacles, but this was reversed. So you were holding on too tightly to something that didn't belong to you. You thought you would lose. You thought it'd run away. You thought you couldn't get another one. You thought you could never get anything like that again. And that's not true. There's something better for you. Only if you're not the miser, though. You find stability when you open your arms to the universe to help you, and you're a part of it. Equal exchange, you know, give and take. Find value in what you have, what you're holding on to, and release things that don't have value, that don't appreciate you, that your time is not moving forward in. The Seven of Pentacles. So that was also reversed. So this is waiting for things to come. The seeds that you planted are going to bring you results. Be conscious that the seeds you plant in your world, in your life, in your dreams, in your relationships are beautiful and fruitful and forgiving and compassionate and full of unconditional love, so that you can have freedom to be whatever you want and feel however you like, and someone else can have that same freedom. Everything is going to be abundant soon. It's coming. Your abundance is on its way. Open your arms, Aquarius, to receive The universe has something very special planned for you, and you might not know what it is yet. It might be better than you ever dreamed. Just wait.